Kia ora, I'm Esme.
And I'm Mackenzie.
And this is your level one tables, equations and graphs strategy video.
So everything that is within the standard is in the name really. You're going to be discussing tables, equations and different types of graphs. And the three kinds of relationships that you need to know for this is linear, exponential and quadratic. Now, the bulk of the standard is really just being able to translate between these three formats. So changing something from an equation to a table or a table to a graph and vice versa.
Now, a background knowledge of geometry, algebra, and fractions is needed for the standard. But don't worry, this video will walk you through what you need to know to ace the standard.
So our first strategy for success for the standard is using the appropriate terms in your explanations. This will also help you understand exactly what is going on in the graphs that you have to analyse. So with the basics, your x-axis is horizontal and your y-axis is vertical, and your coordinates are always written within brackets, beginning with your x and then your y-coordinate. And when you're comparing two lines, where they meet is called the intersection. And you also want to be aware of things like the y-intercept and the x-intercepts. Now, I say plural there because the x-intercepts is where you'll likely be discussing parabolic relationships. Now, analyzing different kinds of data is also really important. So we've got discrete and continuous, where discrete is a given set of numbers, like the amount of children in a room, versus continuous, where it could be theoretically any number on a spectrum, like something like height. So in discrete data, we can't use a trend line, and this is because the data isn't appropriate for this, whereas we can with continuous. It's important to bear this in mind.
A really important thing to remember for the standard is that an equation has an equal sign. A really common mistake that people make is forgetting to put in the equal sign with terms on both the left and the right hand side. For example, the term 2x plus 3 is just an expression. In order to make it an equation, we need to do something like y equals 2x plus 3. If you forget to put in that equal sign with the left and the right, you will get marked down. Another important skill to get used to is being able to classify a graph into its type based on what it looks like. Make sure to get really used to knowing what an exponential, linear, or parabolic graph looks like. Use a tool like graphsketch.com in order to practice drawing and recognizing these graphs. Another really important part of this is recognizing that graphs can look different in different situations. For example, a parabolic graph can be concave or convex, depending on whether it's positive or negative. This difference is really important to know.
Another key tip is to be really comfortable with the constants that you have in your equations. So if we take, for example, the quadratic, y equals ax squared plus bx plus c, we know that a affects our width or our depth, we know that b factorized becomes our x roots or our x intercepts, and c is our y intercept. So by understanding how these affect the transformations on our graph is really important in getting an intuitive feel of what's going on. Quite often what students do if they have an unknown constant is just sub in other points, which is a really useful skill. But quite often as well, we can just get these points straight by looking at the graph. However, we would recommend using an equation if some of your important points, like a y-intercept, doesn't have a clear point on the graph. By practicing these different transformations, you can get a really good feel for what's going on and what you should be expecting in your graphs. A really good key point is knowing when negatives and knowing where negatives are and how they will affect your graph. So in a parabolic relationship, it's going to turn your entire thing upside down so it looks like a frowny face instead of a smiley face.
An important thing to get into the habit of doing is to choosing recognizable and easy to draw points when drawing out your graphs. Most times when you draw a graph, you only need to put in three or four coordinates in order to get an accurate graph. So why not choose ones that are nice and simple to draw? Your marker will be looking out for these things when they mark it, and a messy graph is a really easy way to lose your marks. On that note, it's really important that you practice drawing graphs out. Drawing graphs is harder than it looks, and it's important that you do manage to get things like the slope and the x and y intercepts really, really accurate. A good way to do this is to print out graphing paper or get a maths book and practice drawing out graphs before you head into your exam.
Getting excellence in the standard is quite often reserved for real-world scenario type questions. And what this requires you to do is put the features that you've learned in class and apply them in a scenario that you might be a little bit unfamiliar with. What we want to be doing is marking down all important points and using the context of the question that we've been given to answer the question. So say, for example, we have someone kicking a rugby ball and it comes in a curve. Well, we know that that is an inverted parabola. And where the height of the kick would be the vertex, where the highest point is our turning point where it goes down from there. We also want to be creating an equation that represents this real world scenario. And instead of using the constants like A, B, and C that we've been given in class and that we've learnt with, we want to be using the terms that are used in the context of the question to show that you really are understanding what is going on.
A final important thing to remember is how to graph continuous data as well as discrete data. It's really important to remember here that when you're graphing anything that's discrete, such as the number of rabbits in a field, you don't want to draw a line connecting your dots together. Just stick with the dots. Lines and graphs should only be used when you're using continuous data that can take any value. So your success in this standard is largely based on how much you stress the details. Clear working, correct terminology, and accurate graphs are all key areas to stay on top of. This standard is all about thinking about the wider applications as well. Remember, when you're looking at tables, equations, and graphs, it's not just maths, but they link to the real world applications as well.
Cool, so we've covered a lot in this video, but we haven't covered absolutely everything. We recommend that you guys look at 2 or 3 years worth of past exam papers to get a feel for the kinds of questions that you're gonna get and just to get some good old fashioned study in there. Also, check out our StudyTime walkthrough guides. They're available for free online, or you can buy them in print with next day delivery. And they're designed to walk you through absolutely everything that you would need to know to get through the standard. And so that's all for us guys, and good luck.